against Kansas. The 267th meeting between Missouri and Kansas. And this is probably the last meeting ever in regular season with both teams as common opponents in a conference. Vern Lundquist, Clark Kellogg. Parker, I'm not going to be able to hear you all.
Strapping on. What a scene and an environment and an awful lot at stake.
Fast break off the tip. It's into the hands of Pressey. Now Kim English, number 24, backs it out. Here's one of the Pressey brothers, Phil Pressey, number one. The sophomore point guard picked up by Relaford. Ricardo Ratliff, there's the screen set by Matt Pressey. Entry pass, back outside. Six on the shot clock, jumper. Rebound in the hands of Tyshawn Taylor. Taylor has it again. Quick pass, Elijah Johnson for three. No, rebound taken away by Robinson. He is fouled, he'll shoot two.
Well, Vern, Missouri opened up in his own defense there. Going to try to pack it in and keep that ball out of the paint where Kansas has an obvious and huge advantage with size. And they're going to bait the Jayhawks into settling for perimeter shots and trust that they can miss them.
At the line, shooting two.
Thomas Robinson, now a sophomore, shooting two. Kansas with the first points of the game. They come in 23-5. Missouri, having lost twice to Kansas State this year, is 25-3, but they trail KU by one full game in Big 12 standings. Thus, the additional importance of this encounter between the two. Ratliff with a soft jump hook over Jeff Whitty.
Nicely done. Here in the first two possessions, Missouri has been very content just to run its offense and utilize the shot clock. They will look to get out in transition as Kim English, or was that Pressey who committed the foul?
It was Pressey.
Phil Pressey fouling a jump shooter, and Kim English pointed right to his dome and said, think, young fella, think. Make them earn perimeter jump shots. Don't give them free ones at the line.
That'll put Relaford at the line.
You know, you look at this game, Vern, and Missouri was able to close out the first meeting with an 11-0 run to get the three-point win. Denman scored nine of those points himself. Kansas made mistakes, missed free throws, and allowed an eight-point lead to melt away. But the way Missouri typically plays its best is in transition, just like we saw there. They want to knock down threes, win the turnover game, and score more than you do in transition.
Well, Robinson missed from point blank with the rebound, the putback, and the foul is on Withy, his first. Ratliff, who's been a presence in the early going here, will go to the free throw line. Ricardo Ratliff, one of the four seniors who start for Missouri. They have had the same five starters for the 29th consecutive game now. They only play seven.
And Ratliff has done a nice job improving from the free throw line in conference play. He's up over 70%. From the stripe recently, and that's a credit to the young man's hard work. You know, another point I'd like to make, Vern, the emotion of this type of game, rivalry, Big 12 championship ramifications, NCAA tournament ramifications, it can cut the other way for the home team. Usually you feel like you're energized, you're charged up, you get some additional juice and adrenaline from your crowd, but sometimes when you're home, it makes it tougher to balance that out with execution.
Missouri with its first lead. There's the double down on Whippy. He was scoreless in the first game between these two.
And they'd really like to see him be a presence and look aggressively to score when he catches it in the paint.
Matt Pressey picks up his second foul. See if Frank Haith goes to the bench. He will. And he's got a pretty good backup in Michael Dixon Jr.
One of the best in the country in terms of six men.
There's Frank Haith in his first year as the head coach after 8 years at Miami. Very savvy in Big 12 basketball. He served assistant spots at the University of Texas and at Texas A&M twice. Taylor hits the first, Dixon on. There's Bill Self in his ninth season as the head coach at Kansas.
And hoping to win the eighth consecutive Big 12 regular season championship. And this game, if they were able to win it, would go a long way towards, well, they would actually clinch at least a tie
right
for the conference regular season championship.
Both teams have two games remaining after this afternoon. Little floater short, put back good. Ratliff again. Good start for Ricardo Ratliff.
And a nice start for the Tigers, keeping this crowd on its hands a little bit here. And the zone defense, Missouri employing, trying to keep that ball out of the paint.
Robinson hits a soft jumper. 1 point, Kansas lead. Whistle and a foul. Oh, injury. It's Withy, no foul. Favoring his left ankle. Boy, he has been a force for KU since that drought in the first Missouri game.
That's exactly right.
And they need big things out of him in this one, I think.
Well, how about 16 points, 10 rebounds a game in his last five, but he's heading to the locker room right now. That does not look good.
Kevin Young on, number 40. Junior, a transfer from Loyola Marymount. English back outside. Dixon off the front rim. Robinson's a rebound. He'll run. No numbers. Feed left side. Relaford. And a no offensive foul. Offensive foul on Robinson. His first.
Well, here you see Relaford trying. He does split two defenders and then rock. Wow. I didn't see much of a foul there. They called Robinson clearing out, but I thought he just pursued the ball.
Here's Phil Pressey, number one. English, three. He's hitting 46% for the season from three-point range.
That means you shouldn't let him get any space. You cannot forget about where he is.
Even I could
understand. Can figure that one out.
Yeah, I got that. I'm with the concept. Thomas Robinson has just scored off the glass for Kansas. And we are tied at 9 with 16:03 to go in the first half. Robinson with 6 points and a foul called underneath the basket, Missouri's basket. Frank Haith, the head coach at Missouri. No discernible margin by either team. The biggest news early on is that Jeff Withy, the seven-footer for KU, apparently twisted an ankle. And at 17-minute mark, and he has gone to the locker room. In a tie game, 15-53 to go. At the other end, Dixon hits the backboard. Time called. Let's take a look at the Big 12 standings, Clark. Kansas with a one-game edge over Missouri.
Exactly. This game carries so much significance in the conference championship race and also NCAA tournament seeding ramifications as well.
Well, while we've got a moment, let's go back to New York.
All right, Vern, thank you. UCLA, Arizona is now a final. Kyle Fogg, three of his 19. Arizona survives UCLA 65-63.
To KU, he and the Jayhawks, with a win today, will cinch at least a tie for the Big 12 championship, eighth year in a row. It's an amazing accomplishment.
It is a remarkable accomplishment, partner, when you think about how hard it is to beat opponents in league play because they're so familiar with you. The scouting is excellent. The intensity ramps up. I mean, to do that eight consecutive years potentially is just one of the great achievements, I think, in all of sports when you can put that type of success together in back-to-back-to-back seasons.
And just to paint the portrait, with a win, KU would cinch at least a tie, two games remaining for both Missouri and KU. Missouri won the first between these two, 74-71. And it was Marcus Denman who had a huge run at the end of that game for Frank Haight's team. They are in a position with a victory here, and it's a rare occurrence because they've lost 12 in a row at Allen Fieldhouse. But should they win this ball game, they will have the tiebreaker because of two victories over KU. So not only historically significant today, but in the present for the Big 12, a lot of ramifications. 15:47 remaining in the first half of play. $16,200 plus, I'll bet, a couple of hundred other bodies who've squeezed in here somehow, avoided security, and are scurrying around the building. We welcome all of you, to Allen Fieldhouse on the campus of the University of Kansas, 9-9, Missouri and KU. Elijah Johnson tries to break the tie, can't. It's into the hands of Phil Pressey at the other end. Ratliff, who's off to a quick start in this game. And he banks it off the glass to give Mizzou another lead, their third of the ball game. Vern Lundquist, Clark Kellogg. This one historic and significant. Tia off the bench. Another turnover. Denman with the bounce pass. They are quick, Clark.
Extremely. And they want to win the turnover game as Pressey unable to convert inside, but Ratliff doing a terrific job here in the early going.
Here's Tyshawn Taylor. Jeff Withey injured at the 17-minute mark in the locker room. The seven-footer for KU with a turned ankle. From the corner, three-point specialist Connor Tehan. He's the sixth man for KU. And Bill Self getting ready to go to his bench again as Justin Wesley's coming on. On the baseline, blocking foul. It's on Young. And take a look at the current up-to-date Big 12 standings. Kansas with two defeats, Missouri three, two of those to K-State. So a Kansas win today cinches at least a tie for the Big 12 title. A Missouri win puts them into a tie with two games remaining, and they have the tiebreaker edge over KU. 12-11 KU. First game between these two back on February 4th, 74-71. Here's Dixon off the glass and fouled again. Take a look at those on the court on the left. Pressey, Dixon off the bench, Denman, English, and Ratliff. Matt Pressey is on the bench with two fouls for Kansas. Taylor, Tehan, Relaford, Thomas Robinson, and Young for the moment. Second foul on Elijah Johnson. Relaford on, Johnson out. And Michael Dixon Jr. from Kansas City, Missouri on the line. Leads the country in scoring among six men who have not started a game this year. Almost 13 points per ball game.
And Vern, he does it because he can shoot the three, and he's an excellent driver and finisher in traffic.
That's Justin Wesley, the sophomore. Border Showdown. This is the 267th meeting. It will be the last in regular season play with these two as conference opponents. First meeting, 1907. And here we are, 105 yards later, years later. That looked ugly.
Yeah, that's a hard biscuit. That's not a soft roll. Hard biscuit.
That's the shot of a man who's hitting 9 for 18 from the line for the year.
You called it. That looked better.
Right on average. Tied at 13. Here's Phil Pressey.
They really want to try to keep Phil Pressey out of the lane. Very impressed in the early going by Missouri's patience. In the half court, they've not forced it in multiple possessions. They've spread out Kansas, and they'll try to isolate their excellent guards for dribble drives or ball movement and three-point shots.
10 on the shot clock. Taylor gets a block from Steve Moore, who's off the bench. There's the shot from the corner. Relaford has it. Leaves it for Tyshawn Taylor. Robinson getting a rest now. Bill Self telling us yesterday, one of their problems is they've had to play him too many minutes.
Exactly. He'd love to keep him right around 30 minutes a game. He's up at about 32 or 3, and Bill told us that it probably is going to go to 34 or 35 minutes the rest of the season.
Hell ball goes Missouri's way. Well, the Tigers this year, look at third in field goal percentage, and that's after they shot 38.8 in the loss at home to K-State. They only turn it over 10.5 times per game. Great free throw shooting team. They've had just a sensational year.
Phenomenal year, and Frank Hayes, certainly one of the coaches that will be strongly considered for Coach of the Year, taking over a senior-laden team in his first season, being able to get them to this point. And you talk about what Missouri does to win ball games. It's threes, frees, and tees.
Yes.
Three-point shooting, free throw shooting, and winning the turnover game.
12:40 to go, opening half, tied at 13. And good news for KU, Jeff Withey is back on the floor. Bad news for KU, he just got called for a foul.
That's a tough call against Kansas, because I thought Withey was in good position and he went up. I think one of the things that him and Thomas Robinson really do well, Vern, is they body up and wall up without fouling. In other words, they get their hands and bodies in good position and don't come down over the top to commit a foul. And I thought that's what Withey did there. Denman fortunate to be at the line.
Marcus Denman for the season, 90%. 90, now 100 out of 111. 100, and we said they're a decent free throw shooting team. Withey will have to sit with his second foul. And Denman shoots one more.
I think only Oklahoma State shoots better from the line in Big 12 play, and only Texas and Oklahoma State, I think, have made more free throws than Missouri. It's a big part of how they're successful, because they've got guards that can drive you, shoot the three, and play through contact and draw fouls.
Well, this is as big as Missouri can get. They've got both Ricardo Ratliff and Steve Moore on the floor. Here's Tyshawn Taylor, no. Follow, good! Relaford right there. Tied again at 15. Missouri ranked number 3 in the country. That poll taken before their loss at home to K-State the other night. Texas a winner on the road, but Bill Self was not very pleased with his team victory. That one rattles down in the well and comes back out. Here's Relaford, lost it. On the line, turnover. 11:40 to go, first half. CBS Sports NCAA basketball coverage is sponsored by the all-new Buick Verano. Unexpected luxury in a car this size. AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network. AT&T, rethink possible. And by Reese's, the perfect combination of chocolate and peanut butter. Well, let's take you through what has been a very satisfying Missouri season thus far.
It has been excellent. Kansas State, two of the three losses, matchup trouble there for Mizzou, but one of the best shooting teams in the country because they move the ball, they've got multiple weapons, and they can shoot a variety of shots.
And for Kansas.
You look at Kansas leading the Big 12, a sterling record as well. Unbeaten, unblemished here at Allen Fieldhouse. And Thomas Robinson, clearly along with Anthony Davis, who we saw earlier, have a splendid performance in the win against Vanderbilt. Those two guys have separated themselves as the top player of the year candidates in college basketball this season.
Well, we have had seven lead changes already here in the first half. Timeout called by Frank Haith of Missouri. So with 11:30 to go in the first half, we're still tied. Let's take a look at our Applebee's neighborhood favorites. On February 7th, 97, top-ranked Kansas visited upset-minded Missouri. Down one in double overtime, the Tigers' Corey Tate picked up a loose ball, nailed a 16-foot jumper with 5.6 seconds to go. Kansas couldn't counter. Missouri won one of the best games in this great rivalry's history. When you go back to 1990, Clark, they have two teams played here when they were ranked number one and number two, and Missouri won that game here at Allen Fieldhouse. Matter of fact, when they've been top 10, this is the fourth time they have met, and Missouri is 3-0. That one blocked. That's blocked by Kevin Young. Screen set by Young. Picked him up. And as if they needed any instigating, the crowd is up and demands to be heard. Floater, Dixon.
Gotta hit the mute button for him. This team is as focused as I've seen the team all season. When I talked to some of the Missouri players as they were warming up, I talked to Kim English and had a chance to visit with Marcus Denman a little bit. These guys are locked in and know what's at stake, and they are confident they can come in here and win on the road.
Robinson missed that short jump shot. Neither team shooting particularly well right now. Is that a matter of inept offense or really good defense, except when Ratliff is that close?
I think it's a combination. One, early on, the emotion and the adrenaline is flowing and going pretty hot and heavy. But the execution of Missouri has been impressive thus far.
Well, the current AP top 10 has Kentucky and Syracuse, I think, consensus number one picks.
No question.
Number one seeds.
No question about it. They're locked in unless something catastrophic happens. And Kentucky looking like the overall number one seed. We look at the back half of the top 10 there. Marquette got a big win last night against West Virginia.
In your mind, is this a game for a number one seed?
Not this game itself, but it will have impact on who ends up being your other two number one seeds. Not only do you have this having ramifications for the Big 12 title, but also you look at the Big 12 tournament and where these teams will end up seeded and being located in the bracket. So this game has multiple ramifications. Good luck from Michael Dick. This kid has been unbelievable.
Yes, he has.
18 points a game in his last six, shooting a high percentage. How about this, Vern? You look at Dixon in his last seven games, 17 points a game, 70% on two-point field goal makes, 46% from three, and then 83% from the line. That's efficiency at the offensive end. Ratliff has been the anchor inside to start this game so far for Missouri. Running the floor, he's got tremendous hands, Vern. He doesn't bobble a lot of balls, and when he catches them inside, he can finish over people or through people.
And for the season, he's hitting 72% from the field, second in the country. That's Robinson with a little short, soft baby hook. At the other end, Pressey. Jumper. Whoa! When they get on fire from outside, they are tough.
But it's all predicated on the penetration of Phil Pressey, and that's one of the things Kansas worked on yesterday. They've got to try to corral Pressey and keep him out of the lane, because when he gets in the lane, he's not looking to score. He's looking to get it to those three-point shooters.
Dixon with the split between Robinson. Ratliff with the offensive board. Hell ball, possession arrow, Kansas.
Vern, we're seeing some of the things that allowed Missouri to win in Columbia. Good help by Kevin Young. He may have committed a foul, and then the held ball as Ratliff cleaned up the offensive board. But dribble penetration, containing that in Columbia, was a problem for Kansas. Not only does it give the guy with the ball a chance to score it or pass it out to three-point shooters, it makes you vulnerable on the offensive glass. So the key for Kansas is, one, taking advantage of their size offensively, but defensively, they've got to be able to keep Missouri out of the paint off the dribble.
Another miss by Robinson as he goes baseline. Stephen Moore on the floor from Missouri. You've got Dixon, Pressey, Denman, Moore.
And you can see Bill Self going small now.
Yeah.
He's only got Robinson out there as a front line player. Whiffy going to sit, and that's part of the reason he didn't score in the first meeting. He was only able to play 20 minutes.
Another jumper inside the arc for Kim English. Largest lead of the game now, 5 for the Tigers.
And the Tigers have stayed in this zone. Kansas has to be very patient and be intentional about trying to probe the ball inside and get it moved from side to side. Bill Self talks about playing from the second and third side. That means swing that ball and move the defense.
Tehan tries to find Robinson in the paint. Out of bounds. It'll be KU's ball. They suddenly find themselves down with 7:26 to go, first half. Missouri by 5. Both teams with 6 free throws. Ratliff and Robinson have led the way. It's very likely, as we mentioned, that Kentucky and Syracuse will be the first two number one seeds. That being said, let's take a look at our poll question for the week. Who will be the third number one seed? We'll give you a choice. Duke, Kansas, Michigan State, Missouri, North Carolina. Log on to Facebook.com/hoops on CBS to make your voice heard. We'll have your results in the second half.
I tell you, it could be any one of those 5 teams. Vern, the way Michigan State has been playing, I know they've still got some games left before the Big Ten championship is decided. They see Ohio State next week. But if I had to pick a team today, I might tip my hat towards the Spartans based on how well they play.
Connor Tehan is 2nd 3 of the ball game. Senior, redshirt senior, second team, academic All-Big 12 this year out of Leewood, Kansas. That one is thrown away.
Well, that's a pass Steve Moore has to catch because the opportunity was there. He had his guy beat and had a layup had he caught it cleanly. Tehan had struggled coming into this game, Vern. He had only made 3 of his last 16 threes in the 4 prior games, and you've been with me long enough. When good shooters are struggling, when they get out of it, it's because they continue to work and they break out of it in a big way. He's made his first 2 triples here today.
Pull-up jumper, Taylor. Tyshawn Taylor ties it up. So the 3 by Tehan, the 2 by Taylor, 27 all. Kevin Young on the baseline. That's out of bounds. And that is KU ball. March Madness right around the corner. Sign up now at cbssports.com/brackets to be notified when the bracket games launch. Back-to-back turnovers. As we mentioned at the outset, Mizzou only averages 10.5. They've now got 4 in the game. There's Danny Manning, assistant coach to Bill Self. Still the all-time scoring leader in KU history and the leader of the 1988 championship team, coached by Larry Brown, who was also here. Floater, Johnson. KU's lead is 2. the glass, really high off the glass. Dixon.
Between Denman and Dixon, those two guards, despite their lack of size, they make a lot of tough shots off the dribble.
That was a nice feed from Robinson to Kevin Young, and the foul is called. So Kansas goes back to the line. The foul is on Ratliff, his first. Coming up on AT&T at the half, the two Gregs are back in the studio. Mr. Gumbel, Mr. Anthony, and Seth Davis will join him for all the scores and highlights and the latest NCAA tournament news, all coming up on AT&T at the half.
Kevin Young forced into action in part because Missouri likes to play the four guards, and also Jeff Withey may be suffering from that injury that happened early in the ball game.
And two quick fouls. Off the glass and good.
Boy, they are explosive, aren't they?
Oh, this my
Missouri
goodness.
Tigers team.
About as quick, Clark, getting up and down the floor as anybody.
Oh, man, they don't hesitate, boy.
Bill Self, after the practice yesterday, here's a jumper that ties it up. Told us, there's Jeff Withey with two fouls and a twisted ankle. He said the key for us is transition defense.
Yeah, and keeping the Tigers out of the paint as well.
Right, right.
Out the dribble. Boy, we've got a terrific battle going on now. Robinson showing you big time moves in the post. Ratliff has been excellent. Denman from in the basket, almost a half court, he shot that one.
That was like a half-hearted defensive rebound effort between Tiemann and Young. Here's Tehan, he'll put it on the floor. Johnson. Rebound Mizzou.
KU has to be careful that they don't get into a three-point shooting contest with Missouri. Bill wants his team to be aggressive and not pass up good shots, but he wants that ball in the paint more times than not.
Well, Frank Haith. Well, in the series history, you see, you go back to 1990. They were 1-2, and Missouri won both here and in Columbia. And again, earlier this year, both top 10, and Missouri won that one 74-71. First meeting, as Pressey goes to the line, was 1907. And Missouri won the first game 34-31. They liked it so much, they played again 2 days later. And Missouri won that one convincingly 31-12. The coaches in that game? For Kansas, I bet you can guess. James
Naismith. Dr. Naismith, certainly.
Yep. Isadora Stevens for Missouri.
Thank you. I was hoping you would finish that.
Well, I just...
Because I couldn't quite fill in that blank.
I wasn't going to leave that as a trivia question.
Okay, I appreciate it. No. Nice job by you to drop some additional knowledge on us, though.
Well, I don't think anybody from outside Missouri or Kansas, maybe those in the Big 12. Robinson is going to go to the line. I don't think, Clark. Oh, offensive. Wow.
Let's take a look. Nice pass. Good cut by Thomas Robinson. Boy, that's a tough one. Another Ooh. Angle. Oh, I think that's an off. I think that's a block. He seemed to be in the restricted area arc and also was moving.
Yes.
So that's a tough call for Thomas Robinson to pick up his second. I think they missed it there, Vern.
English. Ratliff, Pressey, Dixon, and Denman. High screen set by Ratliff. Jumper from the corner, three.
Basket pick by Phil Pressey. Timeout called Kansas.
Timeout, Kansas. 5-point Missouri lead. Well, a couple of weeks from Selection Sunday. How about Big 12 teams on the bubble?
I tell you what, Iowa State got a big win today earlier against Kansas State on the road. That always carries additional weight in my evaluation. I would think they're, at this point today, I would think they're strongly perhaps looking on the inside of that bubble. Texas, on the other hand, probably a team that is squarely on it based on the little bit of information we have with so much basketball yet to be played. But I think Iowa State, and boy, I tell you, that's a dangerous team. They've got Royce White, one of the most versatile stat sheet stuffers in the country, kind of playing the point forward for them, and they can spread you out and knock down threes from multiple positions for Fred Hoiberg.
Here's Tehan with the drive and the kick out. Top Tyshawn Taylor, guarded by Kim English.
Well, that was awesome. A big call against Robinson.
Yes, it was.
That was a huge call.
Yep. Went to the bench with 3.5 to go. At the other end, oh, almost threw it away. Did Relaford. But Tyshawn Taylor got it. He's guarded by Dixon. As Withy, there's a nice feed. Blocked. Ratliff.
Vern, I see something happening here that could be problematic for Kansas. They cannot, I don't think they can beat Missouri playing Missouri's game, which is small ball. Their strength and advantage is being able to go inside. And if they don't find a way to be able to play Robinson and Withy effectively, Missouri is better at this game than Kansas is. As a matter of fact, they are better at this game than most every team in the country because they've got so many guys that can dribble drive you and spray threes.
And that was Denman. This is a 10-2 run. Floater and a foul called. 2:44 to go, first half. Timeout.
Missouri has assisted on 11 of its 13 made field goals. Ball is here in Pressey's hands. He's going to dribble into this area and then kick it out to Denman for a three. And this is one of the things Missouri does really well, and Kansas really worked on trying to contain that action in yesterday's practice. And then you see there Marcus Morris and then brother Markeith.
Okay, which is which?
Markeith is right there.
Are you positive?
I am positive.
Sure?
I locked it in when I did them the last couple of years, and that's Marcus there.
It took me 3 years.
Did it?
Finally, at practice here a year ago, I noticed that one of them had a wristband.
Right.
I don't see him wearing them in the stands.
No, we only had the face shot, so it had to be based on something other than wristbands there, partner.
Well, because of the NBA All-Star break, there's a huge contingent of Kansas alums that have made their way here. Just an enormous number of guys who've come back. I saw a colleague of yours, Kevin Pritchard, who's with you now with the Pacers.
That's right. Yep. Assistant general manager there.
Bud Stallworth is here, who 40 years ago put up 50 for KU against Missouri. Second highest point total ever. Up and under. Good play. Wow.
Right now, Kansas just has to hang on here, Vern. They've got to execute at the offensive end, and they really don't have any post presence now. With Robinson with the two fouls, Withy with two fouls as well. So that means Tyshawn Taylor going to have to be creative. And then Tehan, if he can get a good look, going to have to be able to spray a three.
In and out. Wesley gets the rebound, but then the putback is deflected. There is a foul call. Jeff Withy, who had such high hopes of being an important part in this game, has played 3 minutes in the first half. Withy turned an ankle at the 17-minute point, came back, and within 30 seconds picked up his second foul. Robinson's also over there with his second. And Justin Wesley shows you again why he's a 50% free throw shooter. Steve Moore back on. It's a lonely feeling, isn't it?
Very much so. Very much so. The momentum has shifted. Missouri in full control of things right now and looking to add to a comfortable cushion here before the break.
Denman. Deflected, saved, kicked outside. It is thrown away. Kansas ball. 1:37 to go. Well, formidable odds against Missouri coming in. Since losing to Texas A&M 5 years and 22 days ago on this court, KU has gone 89-1.
And we were here for the one.
Last year, they lost to Kansas.
Texas,
sorry. Reach in foul, Matt Pressey. That's his third foul. He's back on the floor for less than 20 seconds.
Well, a lot of movement going on among conferences, and the Big 12 has been affected. Nebraska went to the Big 10, Colorado the Pac-12. And next year, A&M and Missouri will go to the SEC. Meanwhile, West Virginia and Texas Christian are coming into the Big 12. Some of us don't understand it all.
It's a crazy, chaotic puzzle as you look at Pressey picking up his third foul. Frank Hay felt like he could take a chance with the senior with two fouls to be able to go 2.5 minutes without picking up his third. Did not work out. And KU sabotaging its own comeback efforts at the free throw line. Coming up empty.
7-15 now. Trap. That's for three. Dixon. No. But look at Steve Moore get the rebound.
When they space you out so much, Vern, it really becomes difficult to rebound the ball because they're taking long shots, which are usually long rebounds. It's hard to block out and go after long rebounds. You almost just have to be able to pursue the ball with speed. And in that game, Missouri has an advantage.
What an impressive first half for the Tigers of Missouri. How about that pick? And there's the shot taken short. But another offensive board, 4-3, and he canned it. Relaford. Would you have believed an hour ago that the Missouri Tigers would come into a sold-out Allen Fieldhouse, lead by 12? Greg Gumbel will be next after these words.
CBS Sports presents AT&T at the Half. AT&T, get it faster with 4G. Rethink possible.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to AT&T at the Half. I'm Greg Gumbel. 20 minutes of play gone by in Lawrence, Missouri leads Kansas 44-32. These guys have been by my side all day, Greg Anthony and Seth Davis. Anything surprising you about this game?
Well, I think if you're Bill Self, the biggest concern was going to be defensive transition, and you know Missouri's going to shoot the ball well from three. But take a look at this possession here. This is off of a missed free throw from Kansas. Look at five guys for Missouri below the free throw line. Now, Marcus Dittman is going to procure this rebound, and take a look at the transition. Quickly, they turn this into a 2-0-1, and Dixon able to get the finish. You cannot prepare for quickness, and that's a big concern for Bill Self, and it will continue to be in this game if they cannot contain defensive transition.
And the irony is the way that Missouri's quickness has enabled them to have an advantage in terms of rebounding, +7 on the boards, and I think Kansas is fortunate to be even this close to Missouri, considering they had to play the last 4 minutes of the first half without Thomas Robinson, without Jeff Withey. Both those guys with two fouls, they need to ride those two big horses if they're going to come back and win.
Kansas with a 20-game home win streak on the line. They're trailing at halftime. Vanderbilt at Kentucky today, Greg.
Great defense by Kentucky. How about Michael Kidd-Gilchrist here? Beautiful change of direction in the finish. Cats up 6 at that point, and then Gilchrist misses the jumper. But Anthony Davis, how about these Player of the Year credentials? 28 points, 11 rebounds, 6 blocks. And here just a little icing on the cake by Terrence Jones as the Wildcats roll.
Kentucky shot 57% from the floor. Virginia Tech at Duke, Greg.
Austin Rivers is going to come up here. I should say that's a game-tying opportunity for Virginia Tech. Does not fall, and then you get Austin Rivers on the penetration and the finish. Excuse me, that's Seth Curry. He had a game-high 19. And then last opportunity for Virginia Tech, unable to convert on this layup. They would have to foul there. And unfortunately, Virginia Tech had an opportunity to win this game on the road. Duke, at times, Seth, has struggled at home.
Duke, 6 straight wins. They win it by 5 in OT. North Carolina paying a visit to Virginia, Seth.
Yeah, this was a pretty ugly game back in Chapel Hill, but that's a very pretty move by Harrison Barnes. That put Carolina up by 6. Virginia, though, got hot from the outside, especially Sammy Zaglinski. Watch him hit the three-pointer. This caps off a 22-9 run that ended the first half and allowed the Cavaliers to take the lead by four. Now they lead by two.
Early moments of the second half. Meanwhile, Villanova at Georgetown earlier here.
Yeah, watch Maurice Sutton here. You see him circled. Otto Porter for Georgetown comes in, absolutely levels him with an elbow to the mouth. Porter was bleeding. They looked at the video replay. They only gave Sutton a flagrant one. I thought he was very fortunate not to get tossed. It didn't much matter. This was all Hoyas from the start. That's Hollis Thompson, the drive, the layup, and this season cannot end soon enough for Villanova.
Villanova's lost four in a row. Meanwhile, UCLA paying a visit to Arizona, Greg.
In Arizona with an opportunity to stay in the Pac-12 race here. Jesse Perry with a nice spin move in the finish up over the top, and then a nice little handoff here to Kyle Fogg to knock down the three, but the game wasn't over. UCLA with an opportunity here at the end to either tie it or win it, but Jeremy Anderson unable to hit the off-balance jump shot. The Cats hold on.
Arizona wins it by 265-63. Number 12, Florida at Georgia, Seth.
Well, you know, Florida coach Billy Donovan had to get on his guys for not really showing a lot of effort, even when they beat Auburn. They're playing this game without one of the most important reserves off the bench in Will Yeguet. They were really struggling from three. That was their first three of the game by Kenny Boynton. They missed their first seven, but they are now early in the second half, and the Georgia Bulldogs own a 10-point lead over an uninspired Gators.
Meanwhile, in Waco, Oklahoma paying a visit to the Baylor Bears.
And Baylor trying to get back on track, but early on, Stephen Pledger here with the fade and the foul. Oklahoma led by three at half, but then Pierre Jackson got it going from beyond the arc, knocking down that three. Baylor up three at that point. Then Brady Heslop here knocks down a three. He had four on the day. That capped a 17-4 run for Baylor.
Baylor wins it by 10. A reminder, this season, AT&T helps you keep up with college basketball action like never before. Visit CBSSports.com on your AT&T device to get the latest highlights, scores, and expert analysis with AT&T 4G LTE. Thank you for joining us here on AT&T at the Half. We'll get you back out to Lawrence for the second half of Missouri and Kansas after this.
CBS Sports presents AT&T at the Half. AT&T, get it faster with 4G. Rethink possible.
CBS Sports NCAA basketball coverage is sponsored by Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports. LG, life's good. And by State Farm for auto, home, life, and banking. Get to a better state.
That's your money.
44-32 Missouri, to the absolute delight of the few Mizzou fans who are here. Are up by 12. Let's take you through some highlights of the first half, Clark.
Boy, it was a terrific half for the Tigers. They came in focused and ready to handle business. 6 of 14 from behind the three-point line. Whiffy went out early with fouls and an ankle injury, apparently an ankle injury. 12 assists on 15 made buckets. Penetration creating high-quality shots for Missouri.
And then we got shot selection.
Well, he loves that left side, Vern. You see it right there. Three of his shots coming from the left side. Three of his made triple. And then Thomas Robinson, who only played 14 minutes, picked up his second foul late in the half, was off to a really strong start doing his work in the paint area.
Now let's take a look at the Coach Zero first half stats.
Well, this is a problem for KU. 7 of 15 from the line, but also not being able to get the kind of presence inside because of the foul trouble and injury to Whiffy, and then Thomas Robinson having to sit the last 4 minutes of the first half.
Danny Manning giving a little bit of last-minute advice to Thomas Robinson. This represents the largest home court halftime deficit in almost 5 years. They trailed Texas by 12. Came back to one. Kim English will inbound right above our spot and puts it in the hands of Phil Pressey.
Well, Vern, if Kansas is going to get back into this, it's going to have to start at the defensive end. They've got to do a better job of corralling the penetration of Missouri.
Jumper over Relliford. That's not a good start.
It isn't, because you're playing off of him, trying to keep him out of the lane. Phil Pressey recognized that and then just pulled up for the jump shot. That's why they're so dangerous. They can shoot the three on catch and shoots or off the dribble, and if you crowd them, they can go by you. And they're tough. These guys are undersized, Vern, but they play with a tenacity and a chip that allows them to compete at a high level against bigger people.
Well, Matt Pressey, it took him all of 32 seconds to pick up his fourth foul. So I would suspect we will not see him again for quite some time. The senior, who is Phil Pressey's brother, and the son, of course, he is Paul Matthew Pressey Jr., his dad, on the staff of Cleveland, Withy with his first basket. English and Pressey, Dixon, Ratliff for the big first half, and Denman with an even bigger first half. This is Dixon. Relaford is a defensive specialist. He's on in. Now backs away. Ratliff again.
Well, he's almost got a double-double. That's 12 points now and 9 rebounds, and you just mentioned it, Vern. I think he was the guy who jump-started Missouri because he gave them something inside at the start of the game.
Screen set. Entry pass, Robinson, double team immediately from English. There's Withy. Got a height advantage. Boy, did he ever. And he finds Robinson, and a foul is called. Michael Dixon Jr.
Well, I love the way this guy can finish off the dribble, and he gets out in transition. If you don't get up on him, he can pull up and shoot the three. He's got the full offensive arsenal for a perimeter guy.
Robinson, 69% for the year.
He's also a good passer, too, Michael Dixon. I mean, he's not selfish. He'll dribble in there, and if he doesn't have a good look, he'll find the open guy. Robinson has improved his free throw shooting since the last time we were courtside for the Jayhawks, and they were at Texas, Vern, about a month ago.
Yeah. Robinson perfect at the line. He shot 4 times so far. Here's Denman.
Switch that time by the guards, Taylor and Johnson. Now you got to handle the pick and roll action.
You mean
they don't? And they don't.
No.
Withy is just not quite able to move laterally quick enough to handle that pick and roll. You might have to change your strategy on it, but I don't know what you do. You might try to trap it, but then you still got to be able to rotate out of it. I just don't know if Kansas has the type of speed, and obviously Withy is hurt too. He's not 100%.
Right.
He's trying to gut it out, but Bill Self might have to go back to better defensive matchups and trust that Robinson and Taylor can carry him offensively.
From the corner, English. Oh, they're deadly. Such a good shooting team. And it forces Bill Self to use a KU timeout. 17:34 to go in the ballgame. Missouri was hampered in their loss at home to K-State by poor three-point shooting. That has not been the case today.
Not at all. They have gotten good looks, and they have made the most of them. You know, in the three losses, Missouri has only shot 19 of 69 from the three-point line. I talked about threes, threes, and tees. That's who they are, and they're playing their game at a really high level here today in Lawrence.
And for this game, 7 of 15 from three-point range. And Mizzou has given Kansas its largest deficit in a game this year. Relaford, no. Into the hands of Dixon.
Kansas is not a high-volume or high-quality three-point shooting team. And there's Pressey doing what he does so well. Penetrating and puncturing your defense, and then dropping dimes that are room service-like.
Now, he averages 6 assists per game, and that was a perfect example of why he is such a gifted player on this team.
Yeah, he's one of the Bob Cousy Award finalists for the nation's top point guard. The only other Big 12 guy on that list, Pierre Jackson from Baylor. And there you see the largest deficit so far this season for the Jayhawks.
And Pressey now with 8 assists in the ballgame.
I think he's had 5 games where he's had double-digit assists this season.
Taylor. I never thought I'd be saying this here, but that cuts the lead from Missouri to 16.
Well, I've seen Kansas come from behind
right
many a time, and they've got the ability to do that. Tyshawn Taylor can go on many runs himself, but you've got to do it defensively. And when you're down by as much as Kansas is, you've got to stay focused and disciplined, but it's hard against a high-octane team like Missouri.
Johnson at the other end.
They're changing it up now defensively, Byrne.
Yes.
They're going to a zone. Kansas is going to try to play a zone here and see if they can disrupt what Missouri is doing.
English back to pressing.
Actually, looks like this time, yeah, it was a zone. But you got a rebound and misses.
Saved by Robinson.
Really just kind of trying to slough off there for the Jayhawks.
Connor Tehan's on the floor now. And he is the three-point specialist on this team. Here's Robinson. Puts it up. Rebound English for Missouri. Short. Tehan. Kansas. Johnson, Tehan. This is Taylor. Tries to drive by. Does. Johnson spot up three. And a foul is called. The basket went in. The foul is on Rattler as Robinson hits the deck. How about that?
Yeah, penetration by Tyshawn Taylor. Boy, he was close to traveling before that pass, but a little late for the Jayhawks.
Hey. Take you quickly through this week's RPI Top 10. Take a look at this. Syracuse, Duke, Michigan State, Kentucky, North Carolina, followed by, there's Kansas, Michigan 10th, and no Mizzou.
They are actually 13th in the latest RPI, but it's another indicator as to what the RPI is. It is an indicator, one of many tools used by the selection committee. And as you watch this Missouri Tigers team play, it's hard not to think that they're not one of the top seven or eight teams in the country.
You know, when is the RPI going to include an eyeball test?
Oh, it does. The committee. You know? That's why we have the 10-person committee.
All right.
That's right.
Okay.
Yeah, that's how that happens.
I'm just guessing that they're among the top 10 teams.
No question.
Are they, Missouri, the quickest team you've seen this year? Off the top of your head?
They're right there.
Okay.
I've not seen a quicker team. Let's put it that way.
Okay. Jumper, English, short. Johnson. He's got it. Missouri back in transition defense, though.
I would probably put Kentucky in that conversation in terms of speed and quickness. They've got a little length and size to go along with it, which makes them, in my mind, the clear number one team in the country, which they've been most of the season.
There's the double team. Here's Robinson. Turnaround jumper.
Tough shot there.
Yep.
I can't tell you how tough that shot was because he was walled up. He didn't have much room, but he found a way to get it over the top.
Lead is 11. Crowd is up. This is an 11-3 Kansas run. From the corner, Dixon. They are deadly.
But it starts again, Vern. I've got to go back to why he's able to get that shot. The penetration. Phil Pressey is able to break down the defense and get into that lane. And when he does that, he is at his absolute best because he's driving to draw defenders and get people open shots.
Now, Marcus Denman listed at 6'3", and he averages 5.5 rebounds per game. He just got another one. Despite their small nature, this Missouri team does have a rebounding edge over games in the course of the season. Not much.
They're actually winning the rebound battle here against Kansas. At least they were at halftime.
Yes.
A comfortable margin at the last break. They were plus 8 on the glass, so another reason why they're on top double digits. Good defense that time by KU.
Shot clock violation.
Yep.
Jeff Whitty back, again limited to 3 minutes in the first half because of, and we never were told if indeed it was a turned ankle.
I can't tell if it was an ankle or knee, but he's obviously a little gimpy and just trying to fight through it for his team. And you know the young man wanted to come back from his prior performance against Missouri and have a big game, and still has time to perhaps contribute, but he certainly is not 100%.
Well, two blocks there, the last by Steve Moore, knocked it away from Withy, and yet again, here is Missouri with the ball.
I think the Tigers will be content, Vern, to be methodical and patient in the half court, because they've been able to get quality shots off dribble penetration.
How about that?
That's a tough shot there, but he can make tough shots, driving or pulling up for the jumper.
Dixon has 16, and again, he plays off the bench. Now, he's had substantial minutes today because from the corner tee, that's for three. That's what he does best.
A little bit of the Tigers' own medicine there. Dribble penetration, drive, and kick. And the Jayhawks have made four threes in this half.
But they need to accomplish something at this end. And the loose ball's on the deck.
Jump ball.
Hill ball. Possession arrow, Kansas. So KU will have it trailing by 13 when we come back after this. CBS Sports NCAA basketball coverage is sponsored by the Chevrolet Volt. It's more car than electric. Lowe's. Lowe's, never stop improving. And by DirecTV. If you call yourself a sports fan, you've got to get DirecTV. Bill Self, his team, over the course of the year, 38% field goal percentage defense, and Missouri today, 51%. But Mizzou was above 50% for the season until the poor shooting out effort against K-State.
Exactly. Yeah. They've been at the top of the heap in field goal percentage offense all year long. It's a combination of shot makers and the quality of shots they get. Kansas, though, with an opportunity against this zone to try to get that ball inside and cut further into the deficit.
Look at the quick hands of Pressey. Got it away from Tehan. Here's Denman. Easy.
Tell you what, Pressey can control the game and not hardly and score hardly at all, bro. His quickness, his ability to pressure the basketball.
Well, as expected, the Tigers spread the scoring around.
Well, they've got five guys that average double digits on the season. They share the ball, they take good shots, and they can make tough ones.
And three players today with 16, Ratliff, Dixon, and Denman. Three.
Boy, Kevin Young has really given them some nice energy, Vern. His activity's been good. He's got five rebounds. Four block shots he has, but he's hurt himself and his team at the line, unable to convert them. That one looked nice. Good rotation and good result.
Now Dixon's back on the floor.
I'll give Phil Pressey a chance to get a break.
And Matthew Pressey, his older brother, is back on the floor. He does play with four fouls.
Well, Frank Haith would like to get something from Matt Pressey in order to have Flip Pressey available and rested for the stretch run.
Loose ball. English, how about that little in-the-air maneuver? And it's back to a 16-point margin. Mizzou has not won here in the last 12 trips. Kevin Young slams it on.
Nicely done by Tyshawn Taylor. Beautiful penetration under control and the bounce pass. One of the other things about this game, Missouri has seemed to come up with more of the loose balls. Mm-hmm. I mean, they've got a pit bull tenacity to them that has helped them get this lead. And that's something that I think you don't see when you're watching them on television, Vern.
Right.
You look at their size, their speed, but the tenacity with which they play is something that you feel and get a real good handle on being courtside. Nice penetration and bounce pass by Taylor, and a good job by Kevin Young to keep his cut alive. He availed himself to this pass by not cutting his cut off short.
That's the 16th foul, the foul on Moore of Missouri. Kansas with no fouls in this half.
Tehan is now 4 for 4.
What did I tell you yesterday when we were sitting here watching him play?
Yes.
What did I tell you?
You said he's going to play well.
He's going to break out of it because he shoots too good. This kid is a terrific shooter. Rotation, squaring up, and he's found his stroke, and his Jayhawk teammates need it.
Back to an 11-point Missouri lead. Denman.
Good defense by Johnson.
Boy, yo-yo.
Until he didn't stay in his stance.
Yep.
He stood up after he had done a good job on the initial thrust.
And that's four on Elijah Johnson, who had a big game in the win on the road earlier in the week when he had 18 first half points and a total of 21. But now he has to take a seat on the bench with his fourth foul. That's the first foul in this half against KU. They call Kevin Young. That's his second.
Boy, the loss of Elijah Johnson with that fourth foul, Vern.
Mm-hmm.
He's a very capable three-point shooter, although he's not shot it well all season. The last game, he exploded for 21 and was starting to find the rhythm here in the second half. And when you're trying to come from behind, you need stops. But that three-point shot is also a nice injector when you're trying to come from behind.
9:22 to go. Missouri leading by 11. Put back no good. Kansas ball. Well, just to re-emphasize what's at stake, a Kansas win would assure them of no worse than the tie for their eighth consecutive league title. A Missouri win would tie them with Kansas, and they would have the tiebreaker edge if the two teams remain tied at the end of regular season play. Robinson! For the first time in this half, Missouri's lead is only single digits. Clark and I are very, very privileged. We get to travel around the country and watch college basketball in a variety of venues. If you are a basketball fan, put this one on your bucket list. It's my personal favorite.
It is right at the very top of my list as well, Vern.
Students began gathering last Sunday evening in groups for the right to be first inside, and they have found reason to stand up and cheer now. English. Rebound, Tyshawn Taylor. Pressey back defensively. Young. Relaford muscles his way in. And he will shoot free throws.
That's an apt description because he did just muscle his way into free throws there. Kept his dribble alive and got his body into the defender. I've been very impressed with the activity of Kevin Young. And again, with Withy being saddled with early foul trouble and also an injury he suffered early in the game, Kevin Young has been pressed into duty, and he's been a pretty good matchup for this small ball Missouri Tigers team.
Well, they have hurt themselves at the free throw line, has Kansas.
Big time, Vern.
10 of 20, 50% as a team. And that was the front end of a 1-1. Pressing. Taylor. Hill ball, possession arrow, Missouri. Oh, it is a foul. Sorry, I thought he held both wrists up.
This is what Pressey does late in the shot clock. Tyshawn got an awful lot of the pumpkin, but he also got some arm as well. And Missouri, very good at the free throw line as a team.
Over the course of the year, 78%.
Oops.
It hadn't gotten a foot away from my lips, and I knew. Jinx.
All coincidental, you know that.
One of two for Pressey. 8 minutes to go. Pressey with 8 points and 10 assists. Taylor, nice.
What a strong move.
And Robinson did a nice job keeping help-side defenders from being able to get to Taylor.
Margin is 8, crowd is up. Dixon can't get around the corner.
Tyshawn Taylor came up gimpy a couple of plays ago, Vern. I don't know what he did, but he is walking around gingerly. Keep an eye on that, folks.
Missouri leads by 8. 9 points in the last 3:10, and look at the 3 points.
That's huge. 5 of 7 here in the second half for Kansas, part of why they've been able to cut what was a 19-point deficit.
And it is now 8. Kim English is going to the free throw line.
Good activity by Young. He's kept a couple of balls alive, and that's part of the run by Kansas as well. And
there's Max Falkenstein, one of my favorites. You know that this is the final game as conference opponents. He broadcast his first game in 1947. He joined the broadcast in 46, but he's seen 118 of these games.
Wow.
Going strong at 87 years of age.
Isn't that something?
Worked with Bob Davis for the last 25 years. He is
a treat.
Wonderful part of KU history.
He sure is a real gem.
Robinson fouled.
Well, KU is in the bonus and has been for a while. Now the question is, can they convert?
Yep.
This is what Kansas wants to do, get that ball into the low box area to Robinson. And Ratliff unable to keep him from getting it up without fouling him.
Fourth foul on Ratliff. Robinson for the day, 4 of 4.
I got one in the game.
So Ratliff will head to the bench. Steve Moore back, number 32.
So far, Vern, what's allowing Kansas to claw back is getting to the free throw line, but also some timely three-point shooting. And the defense has picked up a little bit. Ratliff will have to sit for a while now with those four fouls.
Seven-point margin. High screen set by Moore. Pressey taken away. Tehan has it. After Relaford accomplished the strip, here's Taylor. Closely guarded, foul on Pressey. That's his fourth. So the Tigers with serious foul problems now, and they have no depth.
None.
So Matt Pressey's going to come on with 4 fouls, and his brother Phil Pressey will head to the bench, having picked up his 4th. And Relaford, who struggled at the free throw line, will be back at the line, shooting 1 and 1. He's 1 of 4. Ratliff, Pressey, and Pressey from Missouri with four fouls each.
That's a real problem because it minimizes the ability of Missouri to be aggressive defensively. That's what Phil Pressey is able to do at the point of attack, and there you see it right there.
Tipped away by Rutherford. Out of bounds on the tip. It'll be Missouri ball. Dixon goes left. Tehan got a part of it, all ball. Robinson with the rebound. Here's Tyshawn Taylor. Takes it all the way. No basket. Moving screen. No, foul underneath. I beg your pardon. It was on Moore.
They called that foul on Moore. Well, that's a close one. He seemed to be outside of the restricted area arc. And I thought was in pretty good position. Good aggressive move by Taylor. And that's been the story of this second half. The aggressiveness of Kansas has really picked up.
One more. He's 4 of 5 from the line now. Going to be a blocking foul on Tyshawn Taylor. Well, they exploded after the free throw, did they not? It's a 3-point margin, and they do.
Wow.
Oh,
my goodness. Look where that ranks on the decibel meter. Almost concert-like.
Under 6 to go. Short. Dixon with the 3-point attempt. Jayhawk ball. It's Taylor and Tehan. Young, Rutherford, and Robinson. There's the double from English on Robinson. Back to him. He goes baseline up under. No. Rutherford tries to save it. And does.
The game has changed drastically from the free-flowing, small ball, dribble drive action of the first half and the first 4 minutes of this half to more smash mouth-like. Grind it out. Get it in the paint. Draw foul.
Whoa!
No issue. There's no backcourt. That's irrelevant. That's not a quality
That's
look.
Not, no.
And Bill Self looking at Tyshawn Taylor. Why? Why? You want guys playing with freedom, but you also want savvy.
Missouri has missed its last 5 from the field. The lead is 3 with 5:15 to go. Denman. Dixon. Matt Pressey. There's Robinson defensively. Moore back outside. 10 on the shot clock. Under 5 to play. Turnover. Here comes Tehan. Bounce pass off the glass. No good.
Jumper for three, no. Air ball.
Bad shot there. And that's a couple of times now where Missouri has just simply settled for a cast up three without moving the defense. Phil Pressey at the scores table. So is Ricardo Ratliff. Frank Haight feeling like they're losing rhythm and he needs those guys back on the floor.
Robinson misses. Comes down to Steve Moore. You saw the graphic about lead changes and ties. That graphic has not changed since the end of the first half. Timeout, Missouri.
Timeout.
Missouri still clings to a three-point lead, but they're in the midst of a scoring drought. Team fouls now. 10 for Missouri, so Kansas shooting two from now on. And Kansas with only five. Missouri does have the possession arrow.
Well, they've gone almost 6 minutes without a field goal, have the Missouri Tigers. And part of it has been shot selection, Vern. They have not balanced being methodical with being aggressive. And that happens when you have a big lead. You want to use clock, and sometimes you lose a little bit of your edge. They've got to get back to driving the ball and getting it inside. And when you bring Flip Pressey back into the game, he usually can find something good for you.
And he did. Ratliff was the recipient of the pass, and Ratliff and Pressey both playing with four fouls.
And Pressey can be a little bit of a gambler defensively. He's got to really rein himself in to come up with that fifth foul. He can't look to go for steals at all. Just be solid defensively.
What a pass from Elijah Johnson, who is also back on the floor with four fouls. And the margin is again at three with 3:14 to go. Robinson has 20.
I think Missouri's got to really look to try to drive the ball if they can.
English, short off the glass. Robinson with his ninth rebound, so one away from his 20th double-double of the year.
And if you're Kansas, you play through Robinson inside. Got to allow him to help you get a perimeter shot if he can't go to work in the paint. Well, this guy here can dribble drive you, Tyshawn Taylor.
Tehan inside, Robinson off the glass.
In the paint if you're Kansas.
The margin is one. Oh, what a find. It's Pressey again, and Denman running the baseline, takes the pass, and lays it off the glass to extend the lead back to three. Time called, Kansas. Kansas still has committed only five fouls in this half, Missouri 10. Tigers do have the possession arrow, 73-70 with 2:05 to go. It'll be Tyshawn Taylor, Elijah Johnson, Tehan, Robinson, and Relaford. That's for Kansas.
The no-brainer for the Jayhawks, play through Robinson. Ratliff with the four fouls. Actually, Moore is out there now, so a substitution by Frank Haight. He's going to try to put his body on Robinson.
Here's Relaford. Spin. English. 1:49 to go. Time called once again.
Craig Gumbel in New York. North Carolina trailed Virginia by four at halftime. Came back, led by three. Virginia's Jontel Evans looking for the tie. Not even close. 54-51. North Carolina, a winner over the Cavaliers. Vern and Clark, back to you guys.
All right, Greg, thank you. And time now to see how the voting went on today's Facebook poll. The results were tallied with Missouri up by a bunch, 39% for them, Kansas 28, Michigan State, North Carolina followed that. Here's Relaford. He is now 4 of 7 at the line today. Over the course of the year, 65% free throw shooter.
Well, Kansas was in this position themselves about 3 weeks ago, right?
Yeah.
In terms of trying to close it out after having a lead, not as large a lead, but trying to hold down, hold on. Let's see if they've learned what it's going to take to finish a tight one late.
Pressey. Denman. Pump fake goes by Relliford. Dish underneath. Foul call. And another player is down. The foul is on Robinson.
I think it's Denman.
It is Denman.
He took a shot after he got into the lane. And not sure exactly what, where the problem is, but he's trying to walk it off and talk it off, claiming he was fouled. Looks like he's grabbing his shoulder, but he made a nice pass to Ratliff, who will have two free throws after he was fouled by Thomas Robinson.
This is, as we've said throughout, just an outstanding free throw team. Never more so than in the last 2 minutes of the game, where as a team, they're hitting 79.5%.
Yep.
And now you've got Ricardo Ratliff at the line. 2 of 2 so far.
Pure.
Smooth.
All rope, we call it.
Matt Pressey's going to come on the floor. And his brother Phil will take a rest. Denman still trying to shake off whatever it was. I think you're right. I think it was a shoulder.
Uh-huh. Offense, defense substitutions here by Frank Hayes. Done a nice job. He's going to get Ratliff out of there now and get Steve Moore back in to bang with Robinson in the paint.
Missouri for the game, 12 of 14 from the line. Something they've done all year long.
Yeah, Kansas has won the volume game at the free throw line. They've taken 26. Actually, maybe 28 now. That was before the Relliford pair.
Johnson looks inside for Robinson. 1:15 to go.
Boy, Moore and Robinson really fighting down in the low post. No double team.
Turn around off the glass, too strong. Rebound Missouri.
Excellent job by Steve Moore to fight him and then challenge him and force him over the top through his body.
1 minute to go. Missouri calls timeout. Missouri has led since the 6:15 mark of the first half of play. The largest lead was 19. It was 12 at the break and then extended to 19 points. KU was clawed back, but they trail by 3 again with 61 seconds to go.
They've got
English
enough,
inbounds.
They've got enough time here, Vern, to defend without fouling, but they need a stop. Missouri, on the other hand, wants to maximize this shot clock and try to get something going to the basket. If not, just a high-quality look is what they're desiring here.
10 on the shot clock. Good defense by Taylor. 4 on the shot clock. Tough. Oh, my gracious.
It's halfway down.
Yes, it was.
Well, you got to attack the goal here. You don't need a three right here, Vern. I think a good timeout, you draw up a play to get that ball inside and try to score right away in the paint area. You don't have to settle for a three here. Plenty of time to stretch the game out if you're Kansas.
How about the contested three down in the basket and said, no, not this time. Jayhawks out of timeouts. And should they go to the line, they'll also be shooting two, no matter if it's a shooting foul. But they trail by 3, Missouri 75-72.
Missouri obviously wants to defend without fouling. Make Kansas get a basket over you. You know they're going to try to throw it inside. At least that's what I would do if I was Kansas. Either a drive, hard drive, or a post up. And you want to try to get something fairly quick here, Vern, to maximize that clock.
Well, T. Hatton hasn't missed from three-point range. He will inbound the ball. We've got Elijah Johnson, Travis Relliford, Robinson, And Taylor on the floor. Here's not, Johnson.
Not opposed to a good look at the three if you get one. And that's what they're trying to do.
There's the dish. Oh! Robinson. Oh, he went down hard.
And he was
and
fouled.
He's fouled. He is perfect at the line today. And appears to be just fine.
That's beautifully executed, partner. A little dribble weave action. If the three have availed itself, they might have looked at it, but I think they were trying to get that ball inside off of movement to Robinson.
Perfect at the line today, 6 for 6 with 16.1 seconds to go. This is for the tie. Out Missouri. The Jayhawks were down 19 early in this half. We're tied. Well, they haven't stopped since time was called. No timeouts for either team. Kansas has committed 6 fouls. They've also righted the ship at the free throw line. Remember, they were 10 of 20. Kansas has made its last 9 at the stripe.
That's how you close. You got to make free throws. You got to take care of the ball. You got to get good shots. And you need stops. They've done all of the above. Can they get a stop here?
10.1 to go in a tie game. It's Pressey guarded by Johnson. Takes it all the way. Block. Tip. Overtime. How fitting. In the 267th game between these two old rivals. Robinson, Mr. Robinson, of course. Kansas ties it on a field goal and a free throw from Thomas Robinson, maintains the tie on a block from Thomas Robinson and Bill Self. Only the 8th coach in the history of KU basketball. Clapping his hands. Here's what's at stake once again. With a victory, Kansas assures no worse than a tie for the 8th consecutive season. With a win, Missouri ties Kansas, and they have the tiebreaker edge. And this, as we have said, is the last game between these two conference opponents for the foreseeable future.
How fitting. Let's play 5 more.
Radliff and Robinson will jump at center. KU, Tyshawn Taylor. He's joined by Elijah Johnson, Rutherford Robinson, and Connor Tehan. Defensively, Missouri has Pressey, English, Dixon, Denman, and Ratliff.
And Ratliff playing with the 4 fouls.
For 3. The first lead for KU since 6:15 remaining in the first half of play. Foul call.
Good look for Tyshawn Taylor. He's been playing at an All-America level since conference play began. And that's what you expect from a big-time senior in overtime, playing with confidence.
At the other end, the foul is on Taylor. And here's Dixon, who for the season is 89% from the line. KU 78-76. Robinson, yes! Thomas Robinson has 27. Denman for three. There's the answer. KU by one. Denman now with 23. Tehan closely guarded. Matt Pressing. Back it comes. Relaford short. Rebound. Matt Pressing. And Missouri with a chance to reclaim the lead. Dixon in and out. Robinson with another rebound. He's now got his 20th double-double of the season secure. 27 points. And that is his 11th rebound. Taylor, quick. Fuller got two more. Timeout, Missouri. See the foul situation, Pressey, Ratliff, and Pressey with 40. Johnson has four, and then a trio of players, Robinson, Taylor, Young. There is Larry Brown. He coached this team from 83 to 88. He has remained a deeply loyal part of the KU family and is here. He went on the road with him last week, told me yesterday morning he thinks he's going on the road with him this next week.
He loves the game and has served it and contributed to it at the highest of levels for a long time.
Including a national championship with Danny Manning as his captain in 88. From the corner, a forced shot, loose ball.
And I think it's going to be a foul on KU. And they get Connor Tehan, Vern. One of the things that's happened with Missouri from the time they got the big lead, they've settled for a lot of jump shots. Not in rhythm as we saw in the first half. Some of that is due to the defense of improvement this half of Kansas. But I think a part of it has been just settling and not probing and driving as much as they need to.
Ratliff is now perfect 5 for 5 at the line. Pressey's back, Pressey's gone.
One Pressey for another.
Yes.
Offense, defense substitution. We've made note of that. With the foul trouble, both Presseys and Ratliff have four. And if Ratliff makes this free throw, I think Steve Moore will be back in the game.
Getting ready. He did, and he is. So Ratliff with those four fouls sits down. Steve Moore back. And it's a one-point ball game, 2:11 to go. In overtime.
You know, it's a good move by Frank Cave, and I think both coaches have done an excellent job, Vern. Now it's about your players executing, and that's what you want to see.
And pass, Robinson. No double. Up, under, short. Steve Moore got the rebound. Missouri with a chance to take the lead. Got what they wanted, don't you think?
I think so, yeah. He didn't get the lift on that one that he did the prior time, and give credit to Steve Moore, who walled him up effectively without fouling.
...90 seconds to go in OT. Denman. Dixon. Off the mark. Saved by Moore.
Well, Missouri continuing to settle for the perimeter shot burn. Somebody for them has to try to put pressure on Kansas by driving the ball. I think they're taking Kansas off the hook a bit by settling for jumpers.
Now Pressey short. Robinson out of bounds and a foul is called. That'll be the afternoon for Matt Pressey.
Pressey actually got bumped there as he went to the lane. No call, and Robinson will have free throws as Matt Pressey has been Dairy Queen.
Matt Pressey fouled out, picked up three fouls really quickly, and Robinson's at the line where he's been perfect today, 7 of 7.
At the line, shooting two, Thomas Robinson.
College basketball fans have seen today on CBS. Anthony Davis, 28, 11, and I think 6 blocks. Thomas Robinson, a big time 20-plus double-double for him. And his first free throw missed, but terrific performances by the two leading candidates for Player of the Year today.
From the corner, English. Back outside, Dixon, guarded by Tyshawn Taylor. This for the lead. Yes! Denman! The three-pointer from Denman, who shot daggers at the heart of this KU team in the first game. And he comes up huge with 40 seconds to go in this one. .34 to go. Marcus Denman for the day now, 6 of 10 from three-point range.
You know, he just kind of bided his time. He had been quiet for a while, Vern, and I spoke to him before the game. You know, he went through a slump until he got going again here recently in his last 7 ball games. He said, I didn't do anything different. I basically continued to wait and take good shots, and I knew my stroke would return, and he's proven to be a big-time shot maker and taker. Now, Kansas, similar situation to prior to the end of regulation. You go inside fairly quickly if you can.
What do you mean like that?
Picture perfect. That's the inventory of late game plays that every coach has.
Right.
He showed us a little something different here. Knew the ball was going to pressure up the line. Cleared the backside and got a bounce pass back cut. The prior time at the end of regulation, dribble weave and got it into the post.
They're checking the clock for the correct time.
Beautifully executed play out of the timeout. And we had probably, looks like we may need to add another second, perhaps. Let's take another look at it and see where. Keeping an eye on the left, the game clock, shot clock is irrelevant here. So 27.2 is where we are. So a second looks like it should be added.
They're adding 2 seconds.
Okay, two. Okay.
28.6.
Yeah.
As Mark Whitehead coming over and telling us that neither team may have heard it.
Yeah.
Neither team can sub because that was a timing error.
Exactly.
And so that's helpful, isn't it?
It is, but I think had Frank Hayes been able to sub, you might see Ratliff out there instead of Steve Moore.
Yeah. Yep.
I think you've got to go reasonably quickly here because you're down one. You still want to have some time if you don't score to get an offensive rebound or foul to extend the game.
Jumper, got it! 12.1 to go.
Got a good backshot.
Tyshawn Taylor off the glass and he'll shoot free throws.
with 8.3.
And I think they may have gotten Phil Pressey. And that'll DQ him. Wow. Big time play here by Denton. And this is a tough shot. A runner off the dribble. And then a nice job here by Taylor to go right at Missouri in transition. Well, not much of a, but that's a case of where you're not alert getting back defensively, and you're vulnerable to picking up a cheap one. Not a lot of contact there as you look at Jeff Withey, who's been rendered ineffective today in part because of the nature of Missouri's style, but also the injury to his leg or foot that he suffered.
Well, Tyshawn Taylor is going to be the guy at the line with 8.3 to go for the day, 5.6. He's only a 66% free throw shooter over the course of the first 28 games.
And you go back to the game in Columbia. Tyshawn had a turnover late, actually two. One was an offensive foul. One was just losing the ball. And then he missed a couple of free throws as well that would have positioned Kansas perhaps to close that one out. So he's got another opportunity.
And he shoots two.
Nice to get that first one down.
It kind of crawled over the rim.
They don't care how it gets in there.
You got it. This is for the lead.
I made one against Indiana years ago that hit the back iron and went to the top of the backboard and went in this situation. You think I care?
Kansas leads, 8.3 remaining.
Defensive substitution here, a little more length and quickness on the floor for Kansas with Kevin Young. If you're Missouri, you got to push it ahead and try to drive it and kick it. But you got to go faster than this.
Three to go. Robinson backs away. No shot. KU wins. The Jayhawks came from 19 down. For Clark Kellogg, Vern Lundquist saying so long from Lawrence, Kansas. Kansas wins it in overtime. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports on the road to the Final Four. At the end of the game, there's the last shot, and it came after the clock had expired. Well, for the last game, it was kind of fun. Good night from Lawrence.